Dear learners, today we will discuss about the new unit, that is Understanding Tourism. So in this class, we will discuss about what is tourism, understand the tourism phenomena, then explain the characteristics of tourism, appreciate why and how it is constantly changing activity, list the concepts of tourism, define a tourist, tourist product and destination, and to know what a tour is. So this is about all the major topics which we are going to cover in today's class. So first, the basic thing is like, what is tourism? As you also, like, now you are a tourism student, so basic thing like, what is tourism, who is a tourist? So these are the very basic questions which as a tourism student you should know about it. So tourism is basically concerned with pleasure, holidays, travel and going or arriving somewhere. So these are the motivation. Basically these like pleasure, holidays, so you are planning to go somewhere. So these are the basically motivations that make people to leave their normal place of work and residence for a short term temporary visit to other places. So these visits are basically short and temporary visits, because once you are going to some place, some tourist destination, so obviously you are going there for a short or temporary period. It may be 3 days, it may be 5 days, it can be 1 week or more than that also, but that time it is a temporary visit to that particular tourist destination. You are not going to become owner of that particular destination for that particular period. So it is a temporary visit where you will go and spend some time, you will see different landscape, you will meet different people. So these are the only things which you are going to do in the destination. Okay. So in this process, we consume goods and services. Services like such as transportation, accommodation, food, etc. And receive a pleasurable new experiences that gives greater interest and curiosity. For example, see different landscape, culture, lifestyle, see the people with different culture and hear other languages. So these all are basically different experience which you will get to that in that particular tourist destination. So these are basically different from your routine life, from your routine office work. So this is the motivation, and this is how people are getting motivated and they want a break from their routine life and they go to other places to get all this pleasure. So tourism as a significant phenomena involves a temporary break with normal routine to engage with experiences that contrast with everyday life and with the mundane. So maybe every day you are going to office, repeating the same type of work, same meeting the same type of people. So sometimes you feel bored also. So that time you feel, yes, yeah, I need a break. I want to go to that place where maybe you have in the morning you read the newspaper. In that newspaper you saw, okay, some new destination has come up and they have different adventure activities over there. Or maybe different, like it can be a destination, it can be monument, whatever is of your interest area. So after that you start planning in your mind, okay, yes, whenever I will get a long weekend, so let us go there, maybe with your family or friends, whatever you plan. So from that time you start imagining in your mind, okay, I have to go over there, yeah, I saw that particular thing in the TV, or maybe in some videos you have seen some adventure activities and that particular destination, or maybe some other attraction in that area. So you start thinking in your mind, yes, once I will get the opportunity, whenever I get the time, so I have to go over there. So these things you start calculating in your mind, and once you get a chance, you definitely go over there, you want to experience these things in person. So almost all travel types, the pilgrim, the monk, the merchant, the student, the missionary, the hermit, the refugee, the conqueror, the cure seeker, etc., can be cited as the prototypes of the modern tourist. Like in the past, previously people used to travel maybe for the pilgrim reason, like they used to go from one places to other places to do Chardam Yatra, or different religion, different people have different motivation, or maybe other than pilgrimage, people used to go for the trade purposes. So these were the, in the old time, like that time, we do not give them proper term as a tourism, but from that time till today, now it's a modern tourism. So basically motivations were there at that time also. People used to travel for different purposes, and now we have more and more option, different types and forms of tourism have come up with different activities, different attraction to attract the more and more tourists. So this is how like people used to travel in the past also. So moving away, if we say tourism phenomena, So it is basically moving away from our normal place of work, short term or temporary visit to other places for pleasure, for holidays. So next important question is, what is tourism? So as per UN World Tourism Organization, the movement of people away from their normal place of residence and work for a period of not less than 24 hours and not more than 1 year. So it should not be more than 1 year and it should not be less than 24 hours. Means you have to at least spend a night in that particular tourist destination, then you will come under the category of tourist. So large proportion of the population engages in going away on holiday to places chosen for the anticipation for a intense pleasure. So this is the reason, like many people across the world, they just travel from one place to another place. Ultimately, they want to get a pleasure in that particular destination. They want to experience the different lifestyle of that particular tourist destination. So they want to get meet different people. They want to hear different languages. So these all are the motivation why people travel from one place to another place. So tourism also involves the recognition and collection of signs that represent a reality of another time and another place. For example, camel rides in the desert for a person who resides in the hills. So person who is residing in the hills, so for you can understand for him the camel ride in the desert is a really type of motivation or which will really attract him. Yes, I want to go for a camel ride because they are staying in the hill stations. Similarly, tourist views, requirements, pattern of consumption changes from time to time depending upon their class, gender and age. Why? Because there are different categories are there, for example, from middle class, some from the upper class. Tourists from the maybe say middle class, so if they are going to some tourist destination, so obviously they will look for the budget category hotels, and whereas a tourist from the upper class, they maybe they want a star categories hotel and all that services in that particular tourist destination also. So accordingly, provider of services, they have to see like which type of tourists are coming. So they have to provide that type of services in that particular destination. So tourism professional globally, they work and develop on the new products. Like we cannot give the same products again and again, because with the change of the time and with the changing trends, so they have to think about the new type of products, or they can add more services, more attraction to the existing product so that they can cater the more and more tourists. So this was about the tourism. Now we will discuss about a few concepts. So different writers, they have given their opinion. For example, as per the Bodstein and others, they views tourist travel in a guided groups, isolated from the host environment and people. They remain in an environmental bubble, participated in pseudo events as they do not encounter the real world on the street level. For example, a group of tourists, they have purchased a tour package. So for them, they in that package, the travel agent or tour operator, they have given the all the services, maybe transportation from the airport to that particular hotel where they have booked a hotel for them. From that hotel, they where they will stay, maximum facilities and services are there within the hotel. Only restaurant is there, maybe swimming pool and other services are there. Then from in the evening from that hotel, maybe they have they will go to the nearby area places for sightseeing and all. So again, that is part of the tour package. So in this category, these tourists, they are basically traveling in a group only and they are getting all the services which are packed for them. But they are not encountering the real life in that particular destination. Real life of the local people, how they are staying, what is their lifestyle, what are their customs and all, because they are traveling in a form of group. Some tourists, they prefer to travel as a individual travelers, FIT. So they don't want us everything as a in the form of advance. They will buy a hotel room or they will buy the tickets and everything. Sometimes they just want to have the adventurous experience. They may want to use the local transport. They may want to stay with the local people in their residences and all. Maybe they will prefer homestay rather than staying in the star category hotel, because their motivation is different. They want to experience the real lifestyle of that particular area. They want to experience their culture. What are their traditions? What are their different cuisine they are offering to the tourists, or maybe what are the local cuisine of that particular area. So these tourists will have different motivation as compared to the other category, like those tourists and they're buying the package tour and all. So they both have the different motivations. So understanding tourism is very essential for the professional involved in this activity. So therefore, it is necessary to define tourist, who is a tourist, then understand how tourism emerges from the past till today, how tourism has emerged, how tourism has changed, how new and new types and forms of tourism are coming up. then explain the characteristics of tourist product. Yes, characteristics of tourism product is very important to understand, because there are tourism products, they have like so peculiar characteristics. Then list the type of destinations and identify their attraction. Means the different type of destinations are there, and what all attraction that particular destination is offering to the tourists. It may have different type of attraction. So you have to know, or you have to list about what all destinations are there and which type of attraction that particular destination is offering to the tourists. Then explain what is a tour. So after this, we will now define the tourism. So again, different writers have given their opinions. So as per the Hunziker and Kraft, tourism is the sum of phenomena and relationships arising from travel and stay of non-residents in so far as it do not lead to permanent residence and is not connected to any earning activity. So this definition excludes the day trips and business trips. They are not supposed to be permanent resident over there. So they are going there for a temporary period. It can be 5 days, it can be 7 days, it can be a month, but it should not exceed the 1 year, and they are not going to become the permanent resident of that area. In that case, they will not be coming in the category of tourists. And secondly, they should not be involved in the earning in that particular area, because they are not going for the business purpose. They will just stay over there for some time. They will spend on different activities, but they cannot be involved in the earning activities. So if it is so, then they will not come in the category of tourists. This definition, they exclude the day trips and business trips, etc. Then another definition, as per the League of Nations, so tourism covers the social activity of those who travel for a period of 24 hours or more in a country other than the one a person usually lives in. So this, as per this definition, they are saying it should be other country. Means this definition excludes domestic and emphasized only on the international tourism, because they are saying it should be other than your own country. Means they are focusing more on the international tourism, not on the domestic tourism, because in case of domestic tourism, a tourist will travel within the country, maybe from one state to another state, maybe from one destination to another destination, but it should not cross the boundaries of your country. Whereas this definition is focusing on the more on the international tourism, tourists from one country to visiting other country. So as per the Rome Conference on Tourism, so tourism as a visit to a country other than one's own or where one usually resides and works for the following reason. So reasons are, like, first is tourism, the activity of temporary visitors staying at least 24 hours for leisure, for business, family, mission or meeting. Then it will come in the category of tourism, means they have to spend at least 24 hours in a destination. Then other thing is, that is excursion. First is the tourism, that second is the excursion. So excursion means the activity of a temporary visitor staying less than 24 hours, but not excluding people in transit. So it should be less than 24 hours. Whereas in case of tourism, we have defined like it should be more than 24 hours, then only it will come in the category of tourism. So in excursion, it should be less than 24 hours, means they are, if people are spending less than 24 hours, means they are excursionists, not a tourist. So this definition excludes domestic tourist. Then another definition, as per the Tourism Society of Britain, so tourism is a temporary, short-term movement of people to destinations outside the places where they normally live and work, and their activities during their stay at these destinations, including day visits and excursions. So in this definition, they have included day visits and excursion also. So different definitions have different indications. So all the above definitions indicate that tourism has expanded in its range and scope. Then next is the movement of tourists, like how tourists move from one place to another place. For example, in the top, say tourists is there. So tourists, again, they have two categories. One is the international tourism, another is the domestic tourism. International means travel from one country to other country, whereas in case of domestic, travel is within the country. But in international, again, we have two categories, that is inbound and outbound. And inbound means refers to tourists entering a country, whereas outbound refers to tourists leaving their country of origin for another. So in international tourism, we have again two categories, inbound and outbound. So what is international tourism? What is domestic tourism, with the help of example? So for example, a tourist from India is going to Australia. So for India, that particular tourist is outbound because from India it's going out. Whereas in case of Australia, that tourist is inbound because that tourist is coming to their country. So this was about the international tourism. And other is the domestic tourism. For example, a tourist from Chennai is going to Srinagar. So that means that tourist is traveling within the country. So this is the example of domestic tourism. So this is how we can differentiate between the international tourism and the domestic tourism. So now we will discuss about the tourism products and services. So tourism product is both a physical as well as psychological construction which is challenged to transform dreams into reality. So here I will explain, like for example, when you buy a tour package or when you are planning to go to a destination, so maybe you may contact a travel agent. Nowadays online it is available. So once you see the pictures of that particular hotel, or maybe you have seen the videos, or when you are while booking also you will see the things over there. So that time you have realized, yes, I will go and stay over there. That particular destination is offering different attractions are there, different activities are there. So at the time of buying, when you are paying for that, so you are basically, imagining, once I will go over there, so I will get this thing, that thing, I will enjoy that, I will experience this thing. So in your mind, basically, you are buying a dream only, because once you reach that destination, then only you will able to experience all these things for which you are paying in advance. It's not like a manufacturing product. Once you buy, go to the shop, you buy a product, you will get that product, you can touch it, you can feel it, you can experience, like on the spot, you can read about its feature and all. In case of services, it's not like that. These are intangible in nature. At the time of purchase, you are paying, you will feel it later on, you will experience it later on. So tourist is basically buying temporarily a strange environment, including unique climate and geographical features, and intangible benefits like bargain, luxury service, hospitality, atmosphere, a culture and a heritage which you will experience later on once you reach to that tourist destination. So tourist products are unique. Luxuries, they are more psychological in nature to convert dreams into reality. For example, a tour is more than buying a mere collection of services like aircraft seat, a hotel bed, meals, the opportunity to see the Taj Mahal. So for example, some foreign tourists is coming to India, so they have in their mind, they have seen the pictures of Taj Mahal, they heard so much about the Taj Mahal, so they are basically in their mind, they are imagining, yes, once I will go over there, I will see the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal must be very beautiful, you have heard so much about the Taj Mahal. So it is all you are imagining in your mind, basically it is in your dream only. Once you will reach over there, once you will experience that, then only dreams will convert into the reality. So tourist product depend on a reputation earned by the satisfaction of previous users and on advertising. So here I will say satisfaction of previous user, because it is all about the word of mouth publicity. Maybe your friends, maybe your relatives, they have visited that particular destination. After coming back to their residence, they may share their experience. Yes, we stayed over there, it was really a very wonderful destination, it has so many things, we have enjoyed this and that. So once they will explain you their experiences with you, so you will also get motivated, okay, next time, okay, I will also go over there. Maybe they will show your their photographs to you. Yes, there we have done this activity, there we went for maybe different activities or services, whatever that destination is offering. So on the basis of that, you will also get motivated, okay, next time I will also plan like that. Whenever I get the time, we will go to that same place. Because it is all up to the word of mouth publicity. Whereas on the other side, if your friends, they are saying, yes, we have been over there, but we have paid so much also, but in return we have not enjoyed so much, we feel like cheated over there, whatever we were planning that we will do this and that, but it has not, that destination is not offering so much in real, in advertisement, in magazine and all, it's showing, but in reality we have not experienced. So it means that is a negative thing about that destination. So that's what I'm saying, that a destination which is earning the reputation, it's not a overnight, it will take time. So it depends upon the word of mouth publicity, and again it is depends upon the advertising, and in reality also, if that destination is offering good things, good services, good attractions, so more and more tourists will go over there. So moreover, tourism services cannot be tested, seen, sampled or compared in advance, and it cannot be stored for future use like other normal products. So this is about the characteristics of tourism product. It's not like you can see these things in advance. So now we will discuss about the tourist impact areas. For example, a tourist going to a destination. So in that destination has so many other areas where it will have impact. For example, on economy, then environment, then people, culture, local practices. So all will have the impact in that particular area. So tour can be within the national boundaries or in any place of the world. So it can be within the national boundaries or in any place of the world, because as in the previous slide also we've discussed, like if it is a within the national boundaries, it means that is a domestic tourism, and in any place of the world means it can be international tourism. So it can be anywhere in any, from one country to other country people are going. So nowadays many people they're traveling around the world, so it will come into the category of international tourism. So unique natural or geographical features like the coastline, islands, mountains, health resorts, countrysides, etc. So these all are the motivations for people to travel from one place to another place. Sometimes people stay in the hill stations, they may want to visit the places where they will get the coastline, maybe beaches and all. Maybe they want to go to the Kerala, they want to go to the Goa to enjoy the beaches of that particular area, because in the hill areas they have not seen the beaches and all. So then people from the coastline areas, maybe from southern side and all, they want to go to the hill areas because they want to see the they want to feel the experience of the hill stations, the chilled weather of over there, different lifestyle of the people, and other attractions which that particular destination is offering. So basically these all are the motivations for which people are traveling from one place to another place, from one country to another country, and around the globe. So tour periods, it depends on the holiday periods. Like in last month we had summer vacation in the month of June, so many people traveled around the world if we discuss about our country, many people from the plain areas they visited hill stations, and especially hill stations they were all packed. You will not get the hotel rooms if you have not booked the tickets in advance, because in summer vacation you know it's very hot in this time, so people they will prefer to go to the hill stations. So this is how people, if when they get the time, when they have the holidays, so they at that time the movement will be more and more people will travel. So again, second important factor is prices. So prices, yes, sometimes like they are giving offers, says this much percent discount is there, or maybe during the off season rates will be very down. So for some people that price is also one of the motivation. When it's a low prices, some people maybe they want to travel at that time, but for other classes, people who are in the upper class, they, for them price will hardly matter. Then attractions, what all attraction that destination is offering. For example, some people they want to have the adventure activities, especially in the hill areas, especially during the snowfall period. So at that time also so many people will travel to the hilly areas to have the adventure activities, to experience the snow and all. So they will travel more and more during that particular period. And then activities and the number of destinations, packaged or individual travel, special interest tours. So here again I will explain, like it depends upon the sometime if you are buying a tour package, so that time you will see, yes, in that particular tour package how many destinations are covered, what all activities are included, what all areas which we can visit in that particular within 3 days or 5 days. So they want to get the value of their money if we have spent this much on tour, buying tour package, so they want to see more and more places. So next we will discuss about the tourist destinations. So tourism destinations is a both a site and an event, and these two factors are the attractions. Means either you will go to a site or you will go for an event. For example, like if we will give the example of event attractions, like World Cup cricket match. So like nowadays it is going on in London, so many people are flying over there to see the World Cup. And then like other example is dance festival. Is some famous dance festival which is there, so more and more people will want to go over there, they want to see the dance over there. So other is site attraction. So inside, for example, we have Khajuraho temple complex, we have Taj Mahal at Agra, for which so many people across the world there go over there to see the Taj Mahal. Then we have beaches of Goa, then we have Shimla Hills, like now in summer vacation, like maybe during the whatever people get time, so may not only in summer vacation, people go over there in winter also to experience the snow over there. So these are the examples of the sites. Then we will discuss about the image of the destination plays an important role in attracting tourists towards a destination. And image is not built overnight, but over a period of long time. Because image plays an important role. If a destination has earned a good image, so obviously more and more tourists will go over there. And yes, image is not built overnight. So that's what we said, we have to earn the good image. And once that image is spoiled, it is very difficult to earn it again. So then we will come to the conclusion. And so this is what all we have discussed in today's class. We have discussed about the what is tourism, who is a tourist, then tourism phenomena, then characteristics of tourism, then we have discussed about the concept of tourism, then we have defined a tourist, tourist products and destination, then in the last we have discussed about the tourism products and services. So I have explained you about the products and what are the services and the characteristics of the services, as they are intangible in nature, they are perishable in nature and all. So as a tourism professional, as you as a tourism student, you should know about the characteristics of tourism and what is tourism, who is a tourist and all. So this is all we have discussed in today's class. This was the basic chapter. Thank you.